Hi, I'm Jim, and I guess this is Jim's Gadget Corner. We're going to build a couple of gadgets I need for an upcoming project that I'm going to build out of this 3/4 horse 8-inch bench grinder I bought from Menards. We're going to be tearing one half of it apart and adding another another attachment onto it. You're going to have to watch and see. But in this video, I'm going to build the squares that I'm going to use on that to hold things, well, square and plumb as I weld it together. Today, we're going to weld together a couple of squares made out of some 3/4 inch by 1.5 inch stock. I'm going to make this one, which is a 8x6, and this one over here that I already have clamped together so I can weld it is going to be a 12x7. So let's get started and see what we can do. I got the welder on and set. Throw a little light down here. Once I start the arc, it's a little hard to see to follow the cracks that I want to follow. I guess first we'll just kind of tack it together so hopefully it stays square. I don't think that's going to go anywhere. Not bad for a first time welding something this thick. Let's see, I've got a small square here somewhere. Looked like it stayed pretty straight. And for what I'm going to be doing with this, it's plenty square. You know, if you can see, there's a tiny crack. Get the light behind it. Not bad at all, but like I said, we're going to take this to the shop where I work. I'm going to throw this on a machine and we're going to machine this all up so it's perfectly square inside and out, and we'll get rid of all this extra weld that's on here by grinding it off. Now we got to set up this next one so we can weld that. And the easiest way is to do it right over here on the bench. With the use of this square. Now, we gotta have this hanging off so I can weld both sides. I almost put that on there wrong. It looks like it helped a lot by having that clamped down like that. We're good to go. Well, I just love this new welder. I'm not in your way. Like I said, I'm a little new at welding, but, and that is, that don't even need to be machined, but I can do it anyway, just because I can. Goofy hats that you wear keeps you from burning the top of your head, but that it's not a bad looking weld. That's the first time I've welded anything this thick. I've got that baby cranked up as high as it'll go, and it seems to do an awesome job. Now next, we're gonna go down to the shop And I'm going to machine them so that they're perfectly square and they're nice and smooth on the face. We'll be machining the face on both sides to get rid of that extra weld that's built up. You get enough penetration, you can grind that off and it'll stay together. Hopefully. Like I said, if you have enough penetration. So that's it for this part. The next thing, we're going to go down to work. So hang in there. I'll be right back. Hi, I'm Jim, and this is Jim's Gadget Corner, and we're going to machine up these squares that I welded up at home. First thing we're going to do is we're going to go all the way around the outside or inside or edges, whatever you want to call it, and we're going to machine them perfectly square on this machine. Then the next thing we'll do is they'll come up and we'll take the weld off so it's not sticking up. And in our way on the next operation on that big ugly machine over there in the corner, we're going to clean up the top and bottom of them and make them look pretty. So right now we're just going to go around the outside of this. We'll have to move the clamps so I can go to the inside, but we don't want it to shift as we're moving the clamps. And every once in a while, this great big, I don't know if you can see it, way over in the corner, there's a big ugly blue air compressor that's going to kick on because I have machines running out back, but no one's here. Automation. Isn't it great? This is a fully manual machine. I like these. I don't like the CNC stuff. I like the manual stuff.
Thank you.
can't unclamp one before I clamp the other one. Now we go back around. it. We took the weld off the top. We ran around all the edges. And now it's perfectly square. On the other side, the weld that's on here, we'll take off over there on the grinder. Now, I gotta set this one up and do the same thing I did to that one, but I won't bore you to death. I'll put it on pause until we get over there on the grinder. Hang on. Sorry about that compressor. Now, one more thing I want to do that I've already did the last one is I put these squares back on and I've got them mounted on a 45. So what I want to do is go in and cut a relief back here in this corner. I can't leave it radiused. Otherwise, if I do use the inside for something, it's going to hit on that radius and it's going to rock. Basically, what we want to do is find center by using this outside corner. Then we're going to run in here and relieve that corner. And now we're done. We're gonna go over on the blanchard and make these look pretty. Hang on, we're back. This is a rotary tabled surface grinder, better known as a blanchard. And this bad boy is probably a lot older than I am, and I'm about like dirt. So this is a rotary chuck. It's magnetic. And whatever you put on here, once you turn the magnet on, will not move. But you have to block it in a little bit. So we got some blocking here. You can use any kind of steel as long as it is thinner than what you're grinding. You don't want to hit your blocking. And you just put that in and turn on the magnet. And it's stuck. Now, the first thing we're going to do is come down and we're going to knock these welds off. Then we're going to grind the entire surface, flip it over and do the other side. Now, the only problem is I can't show you a lot of this because once I start grinding, I gotta turn the water on, and if I leave these doors open, it's gonna be a big mess. So I'll leave it open as long as I can. The water off until I hit the steel. want to dress the wheel so it's nice and flat after taking off that weld. Take just enough off the top to make them shiny. Set our stop and wait for it to kick off, which it just did. Now we'll let it run for a couple of seconds and spark out, what they call it. And it's nice and smooth and shiny on the top. I've been having some trouble with this machine, and the magnet does not like to shut off. So when you go to take the parts off, there's still a little, I don't know how you'd want to call it, magnetics holding the part. So you really have to jerk them off of there to get them off. Shut off the magnet, see what happens. Try to stay out of your way. That's the first side. Can't even tell where it was welded. Big one. about 10 thousandths off this side, and that ought to clean it up. Unless it cleans up before that, then we'll just stop it. Took off the mill marks from removing the weld, and we'll let it spark out for a few minutes, and it's done. Well, welcome to my world. This is what I do all day long, run all these different machines. If we're missing somebody, I fill in. Typically, I'm way over there getting the wall running lathe, and once in a while, I fill in on the mills. I run this all the time. No one else runs it. Some of the grinders up front, wherever they need. And I wash the table before I put the parts on for the second time is the table will get covered with grinding grit from the steel and pieces of the abrasive wheel. It's almost like sand. You've got to clean that all off so the parts will lay flat on the table. And there's the second side on the small one. All the edges are machined. It's perfectly square, flat, and parallel. The large one. Now I got a blemish on this one. Right there is a hole. I didn't get enough weld on there to fill that in completely. I didn't notice it. Now, if it's a big deal, just go home and you weld that up, throw it back on the grinder and grind it off. Myself, think I'm just going to leave it alone. End of this video. If you have any comments or questions, leave them in the box below or send me an email. I'll be more than happy to answer them. Now, these do have a very sharp corner on them that I'll have to hone off, otherwise you're probably going to cut yourself. But that's how we do stuff here. And it makes a real nice square. And apparently, I got enough weld on it because it didn't fall apart when I ground it all off. So, until next time, work safe, have fun. Don't forget to subscribe. It is free and very easy to do.